Hello, my name is Banu Patnagar, and today we're talking AMR. Now, what is that, you might ask? To elaborate, I'm joined by Dr. Danilo Lo Fo Wong, our regional advisor on antimicrobial resistance. Hello, Danilo, how are you?
Hi, I'm fine, thanks.
Good, so let's go straight in. Can you explain to me what is antimicrobial resistance?
Well, antimicrobial resistance occurs when microorganisms change or adapt after being exposed to antimicrobial medicines and become resistant to the treatment. There's different types of antimicrobial medicines to different types of microorganisms. For example, antibacterials or antibiotics work against bacteria, antiviral work against viruses, and antifungal works against fungi, etc.
Why is the misuse or overuse of antibiotics such a dangerous thing?
Well, through all these years since the discovery of penicillin, people have been counting on antibiotics to be cured. We certainly did in my family. When my son was only 6 months old, he developed asthmatic bronchitis, which sometimes turned into pneumonia. And it was just a very scary experience for new parents. So each time we were counting and hoping that the antibiotics would work and he would, you know, get well again and stop coughing and wheezing. So we really counted on the cure, let's just say that. But the problem is that if you use antibiotics too often or too much or for too long, the bacteria can adapt, as I mentioned before, and that they can be resistant to the treatment. So you should not, for example, you should not use antibiotics for a common cold, which 9 out of 10 times is actually caused by a virus. And antibiotics do not work against viruses, they work against bacteria. The other issue is also that in agriculture, antibiotics are also used, but not only to treat animals, but also to avoid infections or sometimes make them grow faster. Now, this practice of antibiotic growth promotion has been banned in the EU since 2006, but in many countries around the world, and also in this region, this is still common practice. So you see that resistance can also occur in animals and then can be transferred to humans, either via food or the environment, which means that, we need to tackle antibiotic resistance both in humans, animals, and the environment through a so-called One Health approach.
So COVID-19 has affected every aspect of life, as we know, and of course, healthcare. So, what does antibiotic use in our region look like in light of the pandemic? And what effect, has the pandemic had on antibiotic use?
Yeah, it's a very good question. We've actually seen quite an effect of the COVID pandemic on antibiotic use, which differed from country context and also in how people responded to it. Now, data that has been gathered by the European Center for Disease Prevention and Control shows that in almost all EU member states, the consumption actually went down. Now, this could be because many surgical procedures were postponed, or people had less doctor consultations during the lockdown, or infection prevention and control measures in hospitals actually increased. Now, we don't have that data for the entire region, but we do get some alarming reports from our colleagues in WHO country offices and national counterparts that, in many instances, the antibiotic consumption actually has gone up. And this could be due because that doctors either did not have access to treatment guidelines or had incorrect information, but also people could go and buy over the counter in pharmacies without ever seeing a doctor and whatever thought that, in the hope that it would protect them against getting COVID-19. Now, as I mentioned before, antibiotics do not cure viral infections, such as the one caused by COVID-19.
So tell us, what can people do to ensure that antibiotics continue to save lives?
Well, first of all, I think we need to acknowledge that antibiotic resistance occurs naturally, but the misuse and overuse of antibiotics in humans and animals greatly accelerates that process. So we need to handle antibiotics with care to make sure that we have this cure and this possibility for as long as possible. Now, to start close to home, the first thing, the old saying, prevention is better than cure, also applies here. Every infection that is prevented is one that doesn't need treatment, right? So, as we've learned through COVID, good hygiene, both at home, in schools, at work, and in the hospitals is key. And second of all, you should not use antibiotics without a doctor's prescription. If the doctor judges that you don't need antibiotics, then listen to the advice and don't go out and buy them anyway. I think that's important. most of the infections that we see in the day-to-day are self-limiting, so that means they go over by themselves. So let's leave the antibiotics to those who really need it. And then finally, since we're all consumers, we're all voters, and sometimes, you know, when we become patients, we are counting on a cure. So we can make sure and demand of our leaders and our food producers that they take the threat of antibiotic resistance seriously.
Thank you, Danilo. So every year in the European region, tens of thousands of people die from antibiotic resistance. So it's really important that everyone plays their part and uses antibiotics responsibly.